Yes, I have seen him. He is in very good spirit, and he has taken his breakfast, he's taking his medication, and he is, as I've said, we spoke, and I also told him that I'm going to tell the nation that he is here in this facility, and he said it's important that this country must know. So he's in very good spirit, and I think he looks well and fine. Can take our word that he is indeed in this facility, and I've seen some of you in the morning when they brought him in here. You are here, so there's no reason why we can lie to South Africans that he is inside here while he's hiding somewhere. There is no reason whatsoever. It's a judgment. We all don't know what the judgment is going to be. So we will await the judgment, and upon release of the judgment, we'll study the judgment, and then it will direct us what to do. So that's what we're going to do with regards to the Peter Maritzburg High Court ruling, including the ruling that may come out in the Concord, in the hearing that is going to happen on Monday. We also don't know when the Concord will make its ruling. So we will await and be guided by the court order of the Constitutional Court. The incarceration of the former president or of any inmate, we are administering it in terms of the act. There is no favoritism. Whether he's my enemy, or he's my friend, or he's my brother, or he's my father, he's my uncle, or he's my political faction or my non-political faction, it is neither here nor there. We are administering all processes guided by the Correctional Services Act. As precaution and in line with the COVID-19 measures, the former president will be placed in isolation for a period of 14 days. Furthermore, he will be assessed by our medical team in conjunction with the South African Health Military Services, and this will determine the conditions of his incarceration. This assessment is done to determine the major risks and needs of the offender. In this case, there is no stipulation for the non-parole period. Effectively means that the former president will be eligible for parole once a quarter of his sentence has been served. We want to assure all South Africans that former President Zuma will be afforded dignity throughout his term of incarceration.
We were there when no other newspaper dared print on a Sunday, when the war to end all wars was declared, when one of our own reached for the stars, and when small acts of defiance opened the world's eyes. We were there when a heart got a second chance at beating, when a great rivalry ignited, and when a country rose out of the depths of division to unite. Because for 115 years, we've been bringing you the right now. Sunday Times, the paper for the people.